Well, a couple of videos ago, I mentioned doing tomatoes a little different than I've ever done them in my whole life. But what we got out here in the greenhouse, we ended up planting a whole bunch of squash on the ground. And what I'm thinking is there's so much massive room above the squash where we could have plants growing. I hate to waste this space. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to install 7 or 8 5-gallon buckets in the air, and we're going to put tomato plants in them and kind of do like an upside down topsy turvy planter, whatever you want to call it, and have those tomato plants grow upside down. I think this could be really cool in the end. It's going to look incredible if it works out. It's going to be really impressive when you walk in here and see these giant 5-gallon buckets suspended in the air and giant tomato plants full of fruit hanging down from the top of the ceiling in this greenhouse. This is going to be really cool. While I'm letting that piece of metal cool down, I'm gonna work on the end supports. They're gonna be made out of wood. Should be pretty easy to make. We'll get them out and installed. Found an old crappy 2x4 that I was gonna burn anyways. This'll work perfect. Well, I completely forgot to film the cutting of the 2x4, which I'm sure everybody really wanted to see. So instead, I think what I'll do is I'll explain what I'm doing here. 1 2x4 for each end of the greenhouse, and marked it in the middle. I'm gonna cut a notch in it to basically cradle. There, that looks terrible. To cradle the pipe that's gonna be running on the ceiling. You can see here, I wrote my dimensions down for the pipe on this handy notepad that I'm guaranteed not to lose, which is the top of a box of screws. So you wanna do stuff like that because you never know when you're gonna misplace things around the garage. That rarely ever happens. So I cut the notch out of here with a sawzall. That way I could get a nice professional look. Looks good to me. Now I pre-piloted my holes. Even though I haven't been out to the greenhouse to confirm that these are exactly where the holes should be, if I guess right, this will save me a trip of walking between the garage and the greenhouse. So I'm gonna go with that math, and I'm guessing I won't be back in here. Well, that worked out pretty good, actually. I guessed correctly. I can't believe it. Well, now on the other side of the greenhouse, we're gonna wanna have the block on this side be the exact same distance away from the top of the greenhouse as the one that we just installed. So we're gonna wanna measure precisely. And we're gonna do that by putting this up here and going, yeah, I think that looks pretty good right there. Only guessed incorrectly on one of them. Just go like that. Yeah, I hear you. You're hungry. I get it. Yeah, I'm hungry too, but we're having Chinese food, so I'm gonna be really hungry later on. Yep, no food. All right. Now, I was practicing this the other night. Let's see if we can get them to do it again. Come on, guys. Yeah, there you go. It's okay. There we go. Come on, Lucky. Get in there. Come on, go ahead. There you go. All right. I don't know why you're getting so worked up. There's enough for everyone. Yep. Come on. It's your turn. There you go. Good job. All right. Well, you guys enjoy that. I think that's going to be just fine. Hang the 5-gallon buckets down. Let the tomatoes hang down. Seems simple enough to me. All right. Well, moving on. All right. Well, I went and got the buckets. Now I got to drill some holes in it. Now, I'm not really sure what size hole should be in the bottoms of these buckets. And I'm not going to go watching a YouTube video to find out. I'm making a YouTube video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this size for the scientific reason that this is the only hole saw that I own. Well, I managed to get a couple of them planted. I found a couple of tomato plants out in the cornfield because that's where the greenhouse was last year. So it doesn't really surprise me that some of the tomatoes fell off and got mashed into the ground and seeded themselves. So that's pretty cool. I'll probably finish up the rest of them later on this week as the plants in the red solo cups start to root out. We'll get that all done, but this is gonna be pretty cool. I'm really excited. This is a neat thing to try, and really makes sense that we use as much space as possible. So we'll see how it goes, and definitely be reporting back later on the progress. Thanks for watching. Hit that like button. Have a wonderful day.